it all around. Go around it with it. You might want to have an open door when you do that. Alright y'all, so today I'm going to be doing a hair tutorial. As you guys can see, I am by myself today. Maritza is actually at work. I'm going to be doing one of my most frequently asked questions, which is,
how do you do your hair?
And it's kind of like a weird process. Every time I tell somebody how I do my hair, they're just like,
what?
Because I use something not very conventional when doing my hair. So I'm going to show you guys how I do that. So here we go. How many things are we going to need? One, two, three, four, five. First off, we are going to need hair powder. This is what kind of gives you volume and kind of keeps your hair together. You don't need this. Sometimes I do it without it, but I mean, it does make it easier. How do you do this? I am not a makeup guru. I don't know the process. It's called Kristen S. It's called hair powder, volume powder. You find it either on Amazon. I bought this one at Target. I use this one because it's a cheaper one. It does the job. It's about $10 at Target. Next, you're going to need some hair wax. Make sure you're using wax. Don't use putty or paste because it doesn't work as well. It makes your hair a little heavier, more flat, I guess. It's called Matte Separation Workable Wax from TG Bedhead. Right there. It's about $11 or $12. I usually get it on Amazon. And then we are gonna need some hairspray for the end. I use Got To Be Glued. This one's really good. It will literally hold my hair for almost 10 to 12 hours. Then we're gonna need a little comb, just a standard comb like this. You get at the 99 cent store. And lastly, we're gonna need the weird part, a hat. Normal baseball cap. You could use a snapback if you don't have a baseball cap. You could even use a sombrero, I don't know. I decided to do this hair tutorial. I mean, I do get a lot of questions about it. Not necessarily like on YouTube, I'm not being like, oh, yeah. No, just like at work and in general. So I decided to put it on a video. If you want to get your hair to do this thing, whatever this is, I think it's called a... It's right here.
Pompadour.
Disclaimer, make sure that when you do this hair, you are ready for the comments. People are going to call you Johnny Bravo, Elvis Presley, Jimmy Neutron. You're going to hear it all. I don't really take it offensively. I wanted to do this hair tutorial now that my hair is still kind of used to this shape. Maybe in the future I'll do the next hair tutorial if I decide to change my hair. If I don't change my hair, then this is what you're gonna get forever. And I also wanted to do like, what if I start going bald and I can't do it anymore? It happens. Just hope it doesn't happen to me. Knock on wood, where's the wood? We're gonna get started. When I snap my fingers, we're gonna go back in time. I know it's a crazy concept, but I mastered time travel. When I snap my fingers, we're gonna go back in time to before I did my hair. Crazy, right? If you guys want a tutorial on time travel, let me know in the comments below. Dang, I'm sweating. It's hot in here. Here we go. One, two, three. Didn't work. Maybe because you don't really believe in it. If you don't believe, it's not gonna happen. I need you guys to really believe. We're gonna go back in time. Ready? One. This is what my hair looks like, pretty much, when it's not done. There is a little bit of product in it, though. It's not completely all natural. I would recommend, though, to not wash your hair before you do it. If that makes any sense. But for example, if you're gonna go out on Saturday, wash your hair Friday night. Don't wash it Saturday morning, just because it's easier to do your hair when it's not straight out of the shower, because all the oils have been stripped out, and your hair is, like, really thin and fine. It's harder to kind of get it into place. Let's start. The first thing you want to do is use your hair powder. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start putting the powder in. So I put it like along the side. Can't really see. I might be putting too much. You don't need to put that much, honestly. Just like a little bit all together. Ooh, that was a lot. Don't do that. I'm putting a little bit more just because my hair is really long as well. So if your hair is not that long, you don't have to put that much product in. So pretty much what I did is I put some along the crease here, put some along the crease here, rubbed it inwards, and then put some in the back and just rubbed it in. Make sure you're rubbing it towards the center, because you want essentially your hair to go up. Now, I'm gonna use the wax. You could also get a gum, but it works really well. It's just a little bit stronger than that one. So the Clash by Johnny B. This is a hair gum. You honestly don't even need that much wax. What I do is I literally just like barely like put a layer of it over my finger. Sometimes people ask me to borrow hair product and they literally dig their finger into it. You don't really need to put that much. Rub it in, make sure it looks like you don't have anything on. Just start working it into your hair. Work it towards the center. The next step is not absolutely necessary, but if you're gonna go out for a long time, let's say it's gonna be a long day and you want your hair to hold up for 6 to 8 hours or so, it does kind of hold it in place a little bit better. Don't go too crazy with this step. This step is the one step that I don't really like doing a lot, just because it does eventually damage your hair, which is a little bit of teasing. Don't go too crazy. You're gonna go bald along the side, along the back a little, go in the center a little bit. That's it. You look a mess. And then you can kind of brush it along the outside so that the outside hair is nice and combed. All right, so after that, this is the interesting step that I was telling you guys about. A lot of people, when I tell them how I do my hair, is like,
why are you using a hat?
I mean, it just works for me. It's worked for me for the last like 3 years. So You take your hat, Monster You, not sponsored, but you pretty much take your hair and then you kind of roll it, like roll it a little bit, and then you put the hat on. Make sure all the hair is going in the direction that you want it to go in. The back hair should go forward, the side hair should go inward, and the front hair, well, that's rolled and it's going backward. Don't put the hat all the way on because then it'll flatten your hair. You just want it so that it holds the position and the shape that you want it to, and you pretty much just wait it out. Usually what I do, put it in the hat and then I go on about my morning. Go eat breakfast, go wash my hair, go wash my face, brush my teeth. 10-15 minutes later, I'll take the hat off and hairspray it, which is what I'm gonna do in about 10-15 minutes. I was cooking some salmon and some rice and some eggs. I'll be right back. All right, so it's been about 10-15 minutes. I'm gonna go ahead and take the hat off now. When I take the hat, I'll just show you. Tutorial, right? So I'm gonna get off my... This takes some cardio. I'm kidding. So you take it off, your hair is gonna look like that, like a little down. What you're gonna do is you're gonna shake it out, go upside down, and then, well, boom, and then, well, boom. It's gonna look super high. Let me move this so you guys can see it better. What you do now is, you don't need to worry about all the hairs being in the right place just yet. Go around it with, you might wanna have an open door when you do that. But what you do is, you hairspray it all around, kind of. You go back downwards, brush it so that it goes in the position that you want it. It's gonna look even higher now because the hairspray kind of hold it up more. Boom, boom. Now you're gonna mold it however you want. Take the rebellious hair, put it back in towards the center. You hairspray wherever you need or wherever you have more hair, wherever like the rebellious hairs are. I think I just ate some hairspray. Bring the hair from the back towards the front because that's the most rebellious hair in the back. Now that you have the shape that you want, hairspray it all around. Don't use too much hairspray because the hairspray will weigh it down. Just enough to kind of hold it in place. This is what, This is what it looks like from the back. I can't see what it looks like from the back, so if it looks awful, let me know in the comments. From the top, that's where it kind of looks like a nest. I mean, everything lasts me a long time. I'm not like constantly having to buy stuff. The wax here actually lasts me the longest. I haven't bought wax maybe in 3 months. Honestly, doesn't take that long because I've been doing it like this for almost 5 years. So my hair kind of got used to it and I kind of got a routine down. People are always like,
I bet it takes you like an hour to do your hair.
No, 5 minutes in the beginning and I put the hat on, go do my thing, come back, 5 minutes in the end, 10 minutes tops. So I mean, if you eventually just get your hair in the routine, used to this shape, it will be super easy later on.
Hello.
Hi, babe. I'm in the middle of filming my video. You're on camera. Say hi.
Hi.
Alright, love you. Bye. 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 Bye, bye, bye. Alright. I should have done this since the beginning. I'm new at this. I am sorry. Alright, so if you guys liked that video, you guys should like, share, subscribe, comment. Let me know down below if you guys have any questions. If you guys want to see other tutorials, see other stuff, I guess. You guys should stay tuned for more. Alright, bye!